All right, I think we're going to go ahead and get started. So on behalf of the Independence Chamber of Commerce, welcome to First Friday. Before we get started, I always like to thank our business sponsor this morning. They are the reason we have the awesome warm muffins, the fresh fruit, and the hot coffee. So please help me welcome our business sponsor this morning, Community National Bank, represented by their president, Julie Volker.
It's our pleasure to sponsor this morning. Just going to say just a few words. We are Community National Bank, and I want to say that community is not just in our name. It's in what we do every day, because I just want to take a minute this morning to talk about my folks. Several of them are here this morning. I think Diggity had to go to school. Several of you saw Diggity running around here earlier, and I think he left to go to school. Lee Beeson is our mortgage originator, cash management, treasury management. If you have a question, Lee can answer it, person. Gary Morrison is here today. Gary is a commercial lender, vice president, been with the bank a little over a year now. So glad to have him back. Neo Deshaies boy. Janet Tucker is a loan, one of my loan assistants, but she also is a vice president or an assistant vice president with the trust department. And we do have a full service trust. And Janet does a lot of work in our trust with our trust folks. So many people know Janet. And if you don't, you need to know her. Angie Musgrove is customer service representative. I think you just took Diggity to school, right? Oh, he had to go potty. Okay. All right. Angie opens new accounts, takes care of any customer issues that we have. She also shepherds Diggity around. Diggity is our special program that we have for children up to age 10. We have a special account for those kids, and one of the things we do is we pay them $1 for each inch that they grow in a year's time. And she could not believe, because I made her pay my granddaughters out this week, and she grew 6 inches in the last year, believe it or not. Debbie Moses is here. Musgrave. I get them confused. Debbie Moses is a new accounts representative and actually handles a lot of the operations at the bank. She can answer a lot of questions. See, I don't know that much. I just surround myself with people who do, okay? Joy Hoos is our teller supervisor and keeps our drive-in in line. So the one thing I do want to say is that all of these folks, not just me, not just Gary. Brian Klubine is on an airplane on the way to a wedding, not his, this morning, but spend a lot of time working in our community. We're always looking for ways that we can give back. And just put up some things this morning. We have our instant issue debit cards. And if you happen to get one that's either the Bulldog or the Pirate, we give $3 to the foundation, to those schools, for each debit card that's issued. So if you don't have one and you're a customer, come get one. Money goes back to the school and it doesn't cost you anything. The other thing that if you know a student who is headed to Pitt State, whether it be an ICC student that's going to go on to Pitt State or a high school student that is going to enroll, we actually do a $500 Pitt State scholarship from each Community National Bank banking center every year. There's a lot that we try to do for the community, and we just appreciate the opportunity to sponsor this today and to help the chamber.
Well, we appreciate you. We truly do. The chamber couldn't pull off all the things that we do without all of our great business sponsors. So, as I mentioned, First Friday is co-sponsored, actually, by the Chamber of Commerce and the City of Independence. And I do see some unfamiliar faces, some new faces in the room. So, for those of you who are new to First Friday, it's an opportunity for all of us to visit with friends, meet new people, network, and then finally just listen, learn, and at the end we'll ask questions so that everyone is well informed about all the great things that are going on in our community. So Speaking of great things, as usual, you have a great program in front of you that has all of the speakers listed, and I already see people flipping them over because they know the drill. On the back, you will find a very lengthy and informative community calendar about all the things that are going on in the community. We will actually be flashing it out this afternoon, and there are three more dates that I will be adding to it when we get back to work. So there's always lots going on in the community. But I wanted to hit a few highlights before we get started. Tonight is Guys and Dolls at the high school, so Friday and Saturday night at 7:30. You can attend the musical. Tomorrow morning, you can take your recyclables to 21st and Maple for recycling. If you get there early, then when you're done, you can head to the Wesley Center and support the Lions Club with the bean feed. That's from 11 to 2. And then if you have your ticket, you're going to be in this room tomorrow night, because that is why it is set up the way it is, because the Main Street fundraiser will be tomorrow evening. If you don't have your ticket, it's too late because they're sold out. So I will not see you if you don't have your ticket. The high tea at the museum, there are still tickets for the high tea. If you've never attended, I encourage you to do so. I did for the first time last year and have a ticket for Sunday. It's a fun event. They have about 10 to 15 tickets left, so call the museum today and get your ticket. I want to give a shout out to the young professionals. You know, this group formed and they have hit the ground running. They have all kinds of things planned. Not only do they do Thirsty Thursdays on the last Thursday of every month at different bars and grills around town in the evening, they also do quarterly events that are informational in nature, which they will be having one this Monday at the Fab Lab. And so I also want to let you know that at their meeting this week, they have decided that on the first Wednesday of the month, they're going to be having coffee and conversation at Annie Mae's for all of the young professionals that are early risers and would prefer to have coffee. So they are catering to all young professionals' interests and needs, and I just think it's amazing that we have a young professionals group in the community. So if you're not a young professional but you know one, make sure you encourage them to get involved and to join the group. I haven't even hardly talked about this event, but I'm going to. On the 11th, you'll see that we have canvas and cocktails at the museum, and I'm going to talk about that just briefly because I'd never mentioned it before, because the flash went out and about 48 hours later it sold out. I didn't even get a ticket. So I haven't publicized it, but I say that because it's once again another great fundraiser at the museum, and we're so fortunate there are so many fun activities going on around the community, raising money for all the amazing things in Independence. So if you're interested in drinking wine and painting at the same time, you're going to have to wait till next year because it's sold out as well. William Inge is well on its way. You know, that's going to be happening at the end of April, April the 20th, but we will be having three more of the Inge movies on the big screen, so check out those dates. If you want to hunt Easter eggs, look at your calendar for the 19th and the 26th. Medical Lodges will be having their third annual Easter egg hunt, and then the big citywide Easter egg hunt will be on the 26th at 3 o'clock out in the park. Business After Hours, I want to give a shout out to them as well. On March the 29th, Hugo's Industrial Supply will be celebrating 30 years of having a standalone store. So we want to encourage all of our chamber members, and they will be doing invitations as well, to be able to come out and support them and congratulate them on 30 years of doing business and an amazing family business at that. Little House on the Prairie, I'm jumping to April. We'll open up April the 1st, go through September, so be watching for all the activities out on the prairie. And we talked about the Easter egg hunt at the park, but we will be having park opening on the 9th. But the day before, at 7:45 in the evening, you can go out and witness the rededication of Logan Fountain and all of its beauty. So be sure and check that out as well. Let's see, Elk City State Park. If you missed Celebrate Independence yesterday, you missed a great one. Chris Hammerschmidt is in the room back here. Chris, you want to give us a wave? He is going to be speaking next month, actually, or no, later in the month, in June, is that right? And but August the 6th, they are going to be having their 50th celebration out at the park. But I will let you know that on the 23rd, they will be having their open house and their park cleanup, so you can mark that on your calendar. We'll be hearing about TEDx. We'll be hearing about the Cessna celebration. We'll be hearing about the National Fiddler Hall of Fame. So with that, I am going to turn it over to our speakers. Oh, I wanted to also give another shout out. I said this last month, and I want to make sure we talk about this again. Not only do we keep a community calendar on paper that we flash out to our membership, we put it on Facebook, we put it on our website, but I also do some radio spots. We do a live radio show on the Coffeyville channel, and we also do a live radio show every Friday in Independence on KIND. So we have a community calendar that also runs that I'll be taping this afternoon. So if there are events and things that you want me to help publicize, please give me a call at the chamber. I would be more than happy to add it to the community calendar. It runs Monday through Friday on Indy 102.9, 94.9, and on the classic hits AM station 1010. So I get a lot of feedback about people that hear that and are well informed about what's going on in the community. So with that, you have your program, you know who's going to speak, you have your comment cards on the table and that you're going to fill out before you leave and leave me lots of good ideas, right? And we have plenty of muffins left, plenty of fruit, plenty of coffee, and thanks to Eva and Aaron's. You want to wave your hand, Eva? Thank you very much for the water that we all have on the tables as well. We are ready to begin. With that, I'm going to introduce our first speaker. She is Diane Freiback from My Town Media. I see her many times a week. I see her absolutely every Friday in the office. And all of you know that April 30th is Love Independence Day, where we are going to reach out as individuals or groups and spread the love throughout our community and watch the ripple effects of that. And I am proud to introduce to you Diane Freiback, who's going to talk about the radio station's Love Independence Project. Please welcome Diane.
Well, hello. I'm here representing My Town Media, and we have 16 stations across Kansas and one in Oklahoma. We're a strong presence here in Independence and across Kansas. We're taking part in Love Independence, and we have three things that come together in a really big way. With community involvement and our radio stations, we can start something really good right here in Independence. I'll start with our Peace Officers Appreciation. If you've been paying attention to the news, and I'm sure you have, police officers have been getting a lot of negativity. And since January 17th of this year, 16 law enforcement officers have been killed in the line of duty. May 15th through the 22nd is National Peace Officers Memorial Week. We will honor our fallen officers with PSAs across our stations. And in conjunction with National Peace Officers Memorial Week, we would like to thank our local law enforcement, and we think they deserve a big thank you and a show of support here locally and across our state. We will record PSAs thanking our law enforcement officers for their service. Plus, we want to partner with our schools. And that is where we'll ask our teachers and their classrooms to adopt a cop. Teachers can take their own spin on how they want to get their students involved. Some may write thank yous, do artwork, invite a cop to lunch, maybe have a presentation at the school or an assembly. It's open to their imagination, and the thank you cards can be displayed in the sponsors' windows or in our downtown area. Plus, the local sheriff's department and police departments are involved in a program called SAFE. SAFE stands for Seatbelts Are for Everyone. Our children and children don't drink and drive. It's seatbelt safety. The schools monitor the students' seatbelt use every day, and there are points rewarded for the use of seatbelts. The school and students will receive gift cards and other gifts in rewards. We're also going to be doing a fundraiser. Here is where we ask the students to pledge to wear their seatbelts, and we record these messages on air and be played. We'll also be doing a fundraiser for SAFE program, and we'll be looking for sponsors to help us raise money for SAFE. We'll be asking for businesses to put out jars to collect money for the SAFE program and broadcast live collecting donations for the SAFE program. We have Dairy Queen that during our live broadcast has volunteered to do free ice cream cones during our broadcast. And we want to thank Brent from Dairy Queen for stepping up on that. All of this is because it's the right thing to do, honoring our law enforcement officers and teaching our children about seatbelt safety. This just may save a child's life. Children are our future and our love of independence. How about it, Independence, are you in? I'd like to introduce my boss, Phil McComb. We've all came together. We've all came together and we worked really hard on this plan, and we feel in our hearts that this is just the right thing to do.
Thank you very much. All right, our next speaker is no stranger to all of us. I got to hear him speak last night because my PEO group took a tour of the Fab Lab, and he did an amazing job. But he is here today to talk about another amazing thing that will be happening out at the campus of Independence Community College. So please help me welcome our entrepreneur, Jim Carell, who will be talking to us about TEDxICC.
Good morning. I get my errant papers in order here. So it's always fun to come to this group, and so I got to say something. What kind of a small rural town in the Midwest sells out so many events? I mean, one day I wake up and I see the announcement for the chamber banquet, and then I blink, and it's all sold out. So I got the jump on the Main Street thing, so I've got my tickets for that, and then you have the museum event. You just never hear that. And so then this young professionals group, so they set up to come out to Fab Lab next Monday. And they said, well, we'll limit it to 40. They've been having so many people. And they said, well, and I said, if you have 80 or 90, we might have a little trouble getting you in and out of there. But so anyway, really a lot going on. And it's unheard of to have these events and have them sell out like that. So and the college is trying to be a part of that. So if, as you can tell by what's been in the reporter the last year or two, ICC has become quite innovative and entrepreneurial. And it's in areas throughout the whole organization, as evidenced by the state debate championship team after never having a program until last year. And so we've got good things going on all over the place out there, and we're going to continue that. So I think, in some ways, I'm becoming the old-timer out there. I've been there almost 10 years now. It's unbelievable. But I think as a group, the staff out there right now is the most innovative and entrepreneurial that I've seen since I've been here. So we want to continue to work to be the most innovative and entrepreneurial community college, not only in Kansas, but eventually in the United States. Like, see, how many of you, I'm going to say this way, are entrepreneurs or small business owners out in the audience? I know there's more than that because I recognize some of you. Okay, now, how many of you had plenty of money to start out? Okay. So almost nobody has any money to start out, and that's what entrepreneurs do. They learn to do things, great things, innovative things with constrained resources. And I think with the changes coming in higher education, that schools are going to have to continue to do more and innovative things with constrained resources. Hence, we need to become more entrepreneurial and more thinking like entrepreneurs, and that's where we're headed. So such is kind of this event, the TEDxICC. And in just a minute, Tony's going to run just a little very short intro video about that. But how many of you are familiar with TED Talks? Okay, so quite a few in this group. As the video will say, it's designed to be a way to spread really good ideas using the internet in a way that's never been possible before. And so Kanye Ore, who's the guy that's responsible for our state championship debate team, has had experience with one of these at a previous life in a community college, and so he helped us get set up to host what we think is the second TEDx talk in Kansas, and certainly the only one that a community college in Kansas has ever done. And so it's kind of a big deal. Normally, you see things like TEDx Barcelona, TEDx Kansas City, TEDx Tulsa. So it's normally much bigger venues for these, what they call locally organized independent events. And we're very fortunate to have one right here coming at the end of April, on April 29th. And for those of you familiar with the Kansas Innovation Summit that we've been having the last few years, we will continue that in the future, but we sort of are offering this TEDx as a special edition of that Kansas Innovation Summit, just because it's such an opportunity for us, and that was a good day to have it. So it's being branded as TEDx ICC, but that's kind of what we're doing this year in lieu of what we're calling the Kansas Innovation Summit, but that will be back next year. So as an introduction to TED Talks, Tony's going to just run this short introduction video. While she's pulling it up, I'll say that if you go to the Independence Community College website and click on Kanye's huge portrait on the home page, it'll go to a page where there's a link to this video, and that's also where we're going to be posting information about the speakers as we get more and more.
Getting access to great ideas hasn't always been easy. Back in the day, you'd only be in the loop if you were literate, educated, rich, and a man. Good thing times have changed. The internet has made sharing ideas a breeze, and no one's doing that better than TED. No, not you, TED. I'm talking about the nonprofit organization that's big on spreading awesome ideas. Twice a year, TED holds this conference where thought leaders from around the world give some mind-blowing talks. Then TED sticks them online so you can watch them for free. Volunteers translate the videos, which means anyone can be inspired by the likes of Bill Gates, Malcolm Gladwell, or Jane Goodall. So what is TEDx? TEDx is a way for you to run a mini TED-style event in your own town. Hold talks around issues that matter to your community, free from corporate, political, and religious agendas. So take part. Don't stop watching videos at TED.com. Keep an eye out for your nearest TEDx event, and if you're up for it, apply to start your own. TED, ideas worth spreading.
So kind of how the day is going to work. First of all, we expect to have well over 500 people in attendance, so we're going to have it right upstairs in the auditorium. Our recruiters are working hard to invite high school students for free from all over the place, especially this region. We're working with the Youth Entrepreneur Group out of Wichita to bring high school students that are involved in youth entrepreneurs from all over the state. So we'll probably have 20 or 30 of them here. And then tickets are just $30, and there's also a link to the Eventbrite site on the same page with this video. We're going to start about 9 o'clock in the morning. The maximum length of the talks is going to be 13 minutes. And there could be some musical entertainment from the college and some of the interludes. And we're not going to have an organized lunch, so at 11:30 we're going to break for about an hour and a half for lunch. And we may have a food truck or two here, and then we're going to alert the restaurants in the area. So there'll be quite a mob of people trying to get something to eat. So we're allowing an hour and a half for lunch, and then we'll go until about the middle of the afternoon with these speakers, probably 10 to 12 or 13 at the most. So I'm not going to try to like list all the speakers, but I'm just going to pick out a few of them and kind of tell what they're going to be talking about, because one of the things TED wants is they want a diversity of topics. So it's really interesting what we've come up with. And I think the first one I'm going to mention is Rodney Walker. Many of you were out at ICC West last October when we brought him in, also with many, many high school students from the area. We packed 278 people in around tables out at ICC West to hear this young man who grew up in a very violent South Chicago, 15 different foster homes, and through entrepreneurship, introduction in high school, and a mentor, he turned his life around and he went from a 2.0 grade point average as a sophomore to graduating and getting into Morehouse College on a probation. And then he graduated from there, and he just graduated from Yale with his master's in just the last couple of years. So just an excellent young man. We've kind of become friends with him. He's actually a Fab Lab member. He's going to come and he's going to talk about the challenges and the need to change our approach to gun violence. And so he's got very personal knowledge of that. And so that'll be real interesting to see what he has to say about that. Ralph Richardson, Dr. Ralph Richardson, was the head of the Kansas State Veterinary Medical School for, I'm not sure how many years, but a long time. And his plan was to retire. And now they've drafted him to run the Olathe campus as an interim director. So he's doing that for a few years till they find a permanent replacement. But he told me one time about this movement called One Health. And that's about the idea that if we take animal health research and combine it with human health research, there's some great advantages in doing that because there's many more commonalities between the two disciplines than we've ever thought before. So we've always sort of kept those separated. So he's going to talk about that. Diane Kander is going to come from the University of Missouri. She's done a TED Talk in Kansas City, and she's a Kauffman Fellow. And she's one of the ones that sort of come out of the closet and talked about how we need to change the way that we educate and inspire entrepreneurs in the country, which is quite an accomplishment for somebody at a mainstream university. I think maybe I'll close with just talking about one of our students. So I believe he's on this award-winning debate team. Braden Beard, any of you know him? Remember him? He's really quite a young man, and the title of his talk is going to be When a Poor Man Looks in a Mirror. I'm just going to read what he gave us for his description. So we provided two student slots, and so we had this kind of competition, actually wider than the college, but so we have two really bright students presenting, and in his description to us, he said, in this presentation, we examine the hindering stigma facing those who come from poverty-level homes. Through the story of Braden Beard's upbringing, we see a story of a young man who comes from nothing but doesn't allow this to define who he is or what he is capable of. A story of ensuring that hope, happiness, and success are traits available to anybody who sets their mind to it. So we've got somebody who thinks like that right out on our campus, and he's really kind of an amazing young man. So it will be a day of inspiration and variety, and for $30, you can't go wrong. So several of us are here from the college, so feel free to talk to us. But if you go to the website, ndcc.edu, and then click on Kanye's huge mug on the homepage, you can get to the page where we've got the information about it. So appreciate the opportunity to be here today.
Thank you. Okay, you were talking about sellout crowds. So Mike and Jim, I think there are about 100 people in the room. So I say, you were saying you wanted to have about 500 people at TEDx. So you're 1/5 of the way if we all buy a ticket. So, all right, next up we have the assistant city manager, Kelly Passour, who's going to give us a demo of the new launch of the city's website. I've already checked it out. It looks amazing. And she's going to show it for us. So thank you, Kelly. I'll dim the lights and there we go.
Good morning. I apologize in advance for all the blue arrows you're going to see during this presentation. You'll understand that later. You might recognize the former website that looked like this. The new website has some of the same features and some new ones as well. One thing I need to note is with the new website, you will need to create an account with a valid email address prior to using some of the services. Once that is done, you simply sign into the site. Let's say you want to have some brush picked up. You simply click on the request to service. For brush pickup, it's under the street department. So you click on that. You fill out an online form. If you really want to get precise, you can even attach a picture of your brush pile. You will see a confirmation screen. Then your request will be submitted to the appropriate party. And a copy is emailed back to you. Okay, now let's say you'd like to rent the Civic Center for a birthday party. You simply click on the online facilities reservation link. and a listing of all the facilities at Memorial Hall and the park are listed. You click on the listing for the Civic Center, and a calendar at the bottom of the page shows you what days the Civic Center has already been reserved. Once you review the calendar and determine a date, you simply click the Request Reservation link, fill out the date requested, click Check Availability, fill out the information about your event, and submit it. You will receive a confirmation screen, and your event will show up as a pending event on the calendar. An email is sent to you, and Memorial Hall staff receives your pending request and reviews it and corresponds with you to confirm your event. We are currently working on an e-pay system that will allow you to also pay for facility rental online in the near future. Another feature, which is labeled on the homepage as Commission Agendas, allows you to download City Commission Agendas and approved minutes. Or, if you click on the TV icon, you can watch commission meetings that have been recorded and uploaded to the city's YouTube channel, thus providing many hours of free local entertainment for your viewing pleasure. The newsflash area includes the latest city news, such as a link to download the newsletter that was sent out earlier this week. I hope you all got one of those. If you didn't, I have some more up on the table over here. I would like to note that the printed version does indicate that the Four Paws Park opening is on April 16th. However, it is actually on April 9th. Oops. The events section includes a calendar of events. If you click on a specific event, then additional information may be provided. If you click on the View All, then a calendar of events plus featured events on the right are also shown. Online bill pay for utility bills or court fines links to the same third-party site that the former site website linked to. So if you had a previous account set up to utilize that service, it has not changed. The Notify Me button allows you to sign up for various notices that you would like to receive by email or text, such as job listings, news flashes, agenda updates, or specific calendar updates. If you're interested in city employment, click on the How Do I, and then Employment Opportunities. Click on the position you're interested in, and the job posting and instructions on how to apply will display. To visit the various departments, click on Government, then click the department you would like to view. Here's a sample department page. Here's a sample zoo page. Another page listing the zoo animals. Lots of information on the website. Here's the Penn Terrace page that currently has over 200 activity calendar event entries. Now this must be a happening place. As you explore the new website, please note that some of the banners are clickable. We would like to encourage you to click on the picture of the biplanes. As you explore the new website, which will take you to the League's Facebook photo contest, which we are currently in round two against Fort Scott, scroll until you find the picture of the biplanes, click like, and share with your friends. Remember to check back each week and see if Independence is still in the contest and vote again, as we are currently behind Fort Scott, so we really need some help. So I'm really serious about this. I would like to recognize the following employees who have and are continuing to work very, very hard to update the website. I'd like to ask them to stand if they are present. The site administrators are Rachel Lyon, Terry Leiberger, and Corey Stanrich, and some of those, two of those are here right now. In addition, we also have other employees that help with the site, Carol McLaughlin, Lydia Collins, Tony Camacho, Barb Berskins, Donna Dean, Lisa Hokenberg, Jennifer Rutledge, Katie Southworth, Brenda Weaver, Callie Haygood, and Cody Shamblin. They have all done a great job working on this website. And last but not least, I would like to announce that coming soon, we will have a City of Independence website app that can also be utilized on mobile phones, because you know there's an app for that. And here it is. We anticipate the app will launch later this year for the convenience of our mobile users. We hope you're patient with us, as there will be some bugs and glitches as we continue to learn the new site format and function. Thank you.
right. I'm impressed, aren't you? My goodness. You were like the most efficient person I know, too. What an amazing presentation. Tony said she got a text from Kelly this morning at 1:45 asking her something about the technology behind this. Oh, goodness. All right. Well, thank you very much. I know that took a lot of time, Kelly, and we appreciate it. And that is an amazing website. It'll be great for our city. All right. So next up, we have the Chamber's Tourism Director. I'm excited to have him here and share all of the details with the National Fiddler Hall of Fame. Please welcome Mike Flood.
Good morning, everybody. I got a surprise for my boss. She doesn't know I do PowerPoints. So this may be a real surprise. Anyway, what I'm here to talk to you about this morning is a collaborative effort between the City of Independence and the Independence Chamber of Commerce, Convention and Visitors Bureau, and the National Fiddler Hall of Fame. What this is a national event. It's a national concert. It's an induction ceremony and everything in between. And one thing it has a lot of is a lot of fiddle playing. And so it ought to be quite a deal. And it's going to be at Historic Memorial Hall on April the 9th at 7:30. And it's going to have five inductees. The primary inductee is a gentleman by the name of Doug Kershaw. I mentioned that to someone here in Independence about 2 months ago, and the comment was, he may be the best that's ever been. And these are world-class fiddle players. We're hosting a national event here. And so think about that. I'm going to talk about that a little bit more here shortly. But in addition to Doug Kershaw, there's Gatemouth Brown. He was a Halsey artist that's been to Memorial Hall before in the past, Joe Holly, Stefan Grappelli, and Terry Morris. Those are all going to be inducted. And Doug Kershaw, again, is going to be the headliner performer. He's putting a concert on as well. And right now, I'm going to stop for a commercial break because we couldn't do this without the help we're getting right now, I'm telling you. We have two presenting sponsors. And that is American Road. You might say, well, what's American Road? Well, that's a national magazine that features travel to various different destinations in the country. And we happen to be doing some work with them right now, and I talked them into being one of our presenting sponsors. So that's what that's all about. Also, Cable One. You know, I used to work for Cable One, and I called them up, and it wasn't a surprise that they just stepped right forward. And they're providing us with a big advertising package and cash to help do this. So just remember that when you think about your cable supplier. Also, we've got some contributing sponsors, and that happens to be, they're not all on this poster here. It's actually My Town Media, and that's Indy 102.9 and 94.9. And I want to tell you that they really stepped up to the plate to help us. There's all kinds of commercials running right now. There's going to be interviews on the radio station and other things, and they really stepped up. Also, again, the Chamber and Convention and Visitors Bureau, City of Independence, and the Booth Hotel. One of our events is going to be held at the Booth Hotel. Also, we've had the Radio Results Group is also helping to some degree. But tickets are on sale. Can you go ahead and cut that? We can just go right on through that one. And that, by the way, that happens to be a picture from last year's event. You see right in the middle of the stage is Jana Jay. She's the First Lady of Country Fiddle, and she's going to be one of the performers as well. And, of course, the Tulsa Playboys is going to be here. They'll be the backup band for the whole show, and also that features Rodney Lay from Coffeyville. You know about Rodney, so he'll be here. There's also some other people listed there. You probably won't know it, but Barry Bones Patton is the neatest guy I've ever seen. He plays the bones. He has the bones, and he makes all kinds of noises and clicks with them. It's crazy. So you might see a lot of interesting things. Next. Here's Doug Kershaw, and he's known as Cajun Fiddle, and he plays a lot of other things, too. He's had 15 charted albums. He's mostly known for Louisiana Man, and you see the way he holds the fiddle? That's where it stays the whole time, and that bow will be in shreds by the time he's done. Okay, next. Here's some of the past inductees. You see Charlie Daniels right there in the middle. Charlie Daniels had his 65th birthday in this building a few years ago. Down on the lower left is Byron Berline. He's from Kansas, and many others. Next. Again, the tickets are on sale. This is a national event, as I said earlier. We need all the support we can get on this, folks. We want to impress these people. The National Fiddler Hall of Fame is a 501c3 organization. They're heavily involved in spreading good words with education and all like that. You will see string players from the school system here involved with this. And we want to fill this hall up because we want to show the support that Independence knows how to do. We're talking about that here today, all the things that we're doing so well here in town. We need your support on this. We want to show them that the hometown is supporting this thing. And one of the things I thought I might suggest was those of you that are here with organizations and businesses and everything, why don't you buy some tickets and reward your employees for all this good work that they're doing? We've got tickets from $19 on up to $49.50 if you want the VIP package. But, you know, buy a package of tickets. Others have already done that, by the way. I've had one gentleman that bought 20 tickets at one time, and he's going to give them out to his friends and such like that. We want to just completely cover that lower level of Memorial Hall, and then we'll get this deal back next year. We have accomplished one of my goals is to get bus tours here in this town. We have one bus tour coming from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. I went down to visit with them yesterday. They already had committed to 40 people to come in a bus. They've already bought hotel rooms for those people. And we added a few more people to that bus yesterday, thank goodness. So that's what's going on. And I don't want to take too much more time because I want to hear from Paula. This is a really significant milestone that's coming up. But anyway, that's what I've got to tell you about the National Fiddler Hall of Fame, April the 9th, 7:30. Buy your tickets now.
Thank you very much. We look forward to that. It's going to be a busy, busy April. So speaking of things that are coming up in April, it's time for our next speaker. Please welcome Paula Schauble from Textron Aviation, as we know it to be Cessna Independence. And she's going to tell us all about the wonderful 20-year celebration they will be having this spring.
Thank you, Lisa. Okay, I'm here to announce that we will be having an open house on April 30th. It's our 20th anniversary celebration of the plant opening in 1996. So we plan on starting at 10 o'clock and wrapping things up around 2. So we're inviting the community to come out to our campus out south of town. Registration will start at 10 a.m. in the main lobby of our assembly building. Upon entering the building, we are planning to give away a free gift to those that enter, along with some daily activities, a listing of the activities that we have planned. We are tentatively talking about a car show, hoping to have at least 100 entries, so we will soon be sending out flyers to the surrounding area. We are going to be serving food, and we will be having a DJ, and we will have a self-guided tour around all of our buildings. So if you're not familiar with our campus, we have an assembly building, a paint building, a flight building, and a delivery center. So we are actually opening up all of our buildings for everyone to walk through and look at our product. Actually, what I'm kind of interested in is the customer center. They're talking about how to make it to where you feel what a customer would experience when they come to Cessna Independence to pick up a delivery. We have lots of things for the kids to do. Lots of games will be outside, inflatables. We actually have a I don't know what they're going to call it just yet, but we'll have little stops around where you can pick up also some little goodies along the way and actually learn a little bit of how we produce our aircraft out at Independence. We have some information booths that will be coming. We will have the fire department and the police department out on site as well. And we plan on having a ceremony with the Textron Aviation SLT from Wichita and the city leaders. And we will also have our static displays on site for you to walk around. I'm not quite sure if you'll be able to actually physically get into the aircraft, but at least you can walk around and see the detail that goes on to every aircraft. So we're still working out on finalizing other activities and details, but that's what I have to announce at this time. So there's about 15 committee members, and then of those committee members, they have individual committees themselves. So there's a lot of people involved with making this happen. So the media will be inviting, or our corporate communication, group will be inviting media out as well. So we're hoping to have a really big turnout, and we're praying for some really nice weather. Thank you.
Thank you, Paula. We are very excited, not only for the day of celebration, but we're thrilled that Cessna is here, has stayed here, and will remain here in our community. We appreciate all that they do to contribute to Independence. They're a very big supporter of our town, not only through employment, but through their financial support of all the events and things that happen in our community. Now it is time to do some shout-outs, some one-minute announcements. I know there are a lot of people in the room, and you might have questions for our speakers. And if you do, we'll take some Q&A for our speakers, and then we will also give you a chance to just stand up at your chair. Tony will give you the mic because it is being filmed for TV, so you can speak into the mic so that everyone can hear it on when it's televised. But you can give a little shout-out if you have something going on you want us all to know about. So does anyone have any questions for our speakers first? Did such a bang-up job, nobody has any questions for you. No questions? Okay. Anybody want to tell us anything that's happening in the community that we didn't talk about? Yes, Steve. We have a Republican and Democrat caucus tomorrow, and the locations would be?
ICC West Republican, and
ICC West for the Republican and Jefferson School for the Democrats. Okay, thank you for that. Yes, what time? 10 to 2. One to three for the Democrats, possibly. Where can they find this information? I got some mailings, but okay. Did you have something you wanted to share?
I just want to know if anybody can explain what the caucus is going to, how it works, and how long do I plan on being there?
Okay. Would someone like to talk about a caucus and how it works and how long? Val, can we give you the mic, though, because... Okay.
I can't promise this is how it would be. I'm not absolutely certain, but I know what I've seen in the past is each candidate has somebody who gets up and speaks for them, and then people vote, usually with their body. I think they go to a corner and represent that person or vote with them, display their support for that person. And then they whittle it down to a point where they have one person they're endorsing. And I don't know that that's how it will be, but I have seen that happen in the past, so that may be the case.
Thank you, Val. I did live in Iowa for a couple years in 2007 and 9, and I went through the caucus. It was my first and only experience with that, and that is exactly how it happened, so... No, I wasn't. No. Anybody else have a shout out? Yes, Barb?
I was late, and I don't know if you mentioned it, but the Easter egg hunt is March 26th at 3 o'clock. In case of rain, it'll be on Easter Sunday at 3 o'clock. And also, Four Paws is planning their park opening on April 9th, and we look forward to seeing you there. Thanks.
How about the fountain?
Oh, the fountain. The fountain rededication. Thank you. Okay, I forgot that. We're going to have that on April 8th,
at 7:45, so be there. It's going to be exciting to see that new redecorated fountain come to life again. So thank you very much.
We're way excited about that. It's going to be an amazing April in Independence. So lots of things going on. Anybody else? Sure, Josh. We're going to wait for the mic.
So we have a famous or infamous person in our midst. Steve McBride, actually, in the Kansas Press Association Awards, swept the cartoon, the political cartoon category. So congratulations.
Congratulations. Anybody else? Well, before we dismiss, I want you to remember and be thinking. We'll be talking about this more next month, but April the 30th is Love Independence Day. And once again, I encourage you to think about things that you can do with your businesses, your organizations, your churches, your neighbors, your families, or as an individual. I am connected to so many organizations through my job that I'm actually pulling away, and I'm going to champion, hence my age, 50 random acts of kindness. So I'm going to be out just by myself in my car. I've got a whole list of things that I'm going to do. And so I just encourage you to do that. It doesn't cost anything to smile at someone, to pay someone a compliment, to open up a door for someone, and to just be nice. And like I said earlier in the program, I look forward to the ripple effects of all the random acts of kindness that will happen on that day. So with that, on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce and the City of Independence, I'd like to thank you once again for coming to thank you for coming to First Friday. And I do want to thank our business sponsor again, Julie Volker, and everyone at Community National Bank. And I look forward to seeing you again, No Foolin', on April the 1st. And our business sponsor on that particular day will be Dennis Shelby and the folks at Independence Family Medicine. So with that, please do not forget to take your flyer that has your calendar on it with you. Pick up some flyers on the table over here for your refrigerators and break rooms. And have a great weekend. Thank you very much.